Hello, this is Adrian for Toots Plus. Today I'm going to show you how to make this quick and dirty wormhole effect using Element 3D. What I like about this is that it doesn't necessarily have to use any keyframes at all, so you can theoretically extend the composition to be as long as you want and make the shot last as long as you want. Also, this effect is very customizable, and I'm going to show you how to quickly adjust it to suit your needs. I've already taken enough time talking about it, so let's jump right in. So we're here in After Effects. Something I've got here is this fractally texture that I put together in Photoshop, and you'll be able to find this texture in the project files, but you don't need to use it. You can use any kind of texture you want to get the look that you want. But I'm going to go ahead and just drag that into our main composition, and now I'm going to add a new solid and add Element 3D to it. Now under the custom layers pull down section in Element, we're going to add a custom texture map, and we're going to make it that fractal energy composition. So now let's go into the scene setup, and under the primitives that ship with Element, we're going to scroll until we find the donut. Now you can set up your texture however you want, but the way I like to do it is just apply this flat color to it, and then turn the diffuse color to white. And then under the diffuse texture, we're just going to load in that fractal energy texture. Now it's looking kind of stretched, so how we can fix that is click on the name of the object, which in this case is donut, and then under the model and surface mapping area where it says UV repeat, you can change these numbers to unstretch it. But if you're using a tileable texture like I am, you're going to want to make these whole numbers so that the tiling stays perfect. So I think I'm going to change this first one to probably about 2, and this next one to 6. But again, that will vary depending on what texture you're using and what your preferences are. So now for the real trick that's going to make this work is we're going to click this button here that says Invert Normals. Click OK. And we're going to need to add a new camera. And let's also go under Group 1 and create a group null. So now let's track in our camera a little bit. And let's move our group null over to the left or to the right, it doesn't really matter. And we're going to scale it up until we have this look here so that we're looking inside the donut. And now twirl down the transform properties for that group null. And under Y rotation, we're going to add an expression. And that expression is going to be time times 80. And what that's going to do is cause it to spin. Now you can alter the number that you multiply it by to make it spin faster or slower. But as we can see, our camera needs some readjusting. So let's take the camera. I'm going to use the track camera tool to move it over a little bit. And the Z track to move it in a little more. Great, I have now got that looking the way I want it. Now, in addition to that, we can add an expression to the Z rotation of the camera, and I'm just going to add a slight wiggle to it. Maybe 0.5 times a second by about 10 degrees. Let's see how that looks. And that's just going to add a little variation. We really want as much variation as we can get to hide the fact that this is actually a donut shape. I'm going to increase the amount that the camera turns. All right, so this texture is a little complicated looking, and it's kind of hard to read, so I'm actually going to go into the render settings And I'm just going to add some fog, but I'm going to make the fog like a blue color. And I'm going to change the range of it just to kind of add some separation between what's far away and what's not. Now let's go back into the scene setup of Element. And we just want to add in something to fly through this wormhole. So I'm going to add a jet from the Jet Strike pack just because I have it. Put it on group two. You can add any kind of ship or whatever you want. So I'm going to hit OK. And I'm also going to create a group null for that jet. And I'm going to spin it around so it's facing away from me instead of towards me. And I'm going to shrink it way down. All right, and that looks pretty cool. So as you can see, we already have a little bit of movement on the jet because it is reacting to the camera motion, which is great. But we can also add an expression to the position of it, make it a wiggle expression, and just make it move around a little bit more. And you can add an expression to the orientation of that null as well. So that's pretty much all you need to know for this quick and dirty wormhole effect. But let's say you wanted to animate the jet actually flying through the wormhole, not just make it an illusion like this, but actually have it disappear through the wormhole. That's easy to do. We can just duplicate the group one null and just give it a new name and take the expression off of it. And then you can parent the group two null to it. And then if you animate the Y rotation, it'll look like the jet's flying through. So let's do that. But now let's say you want to change the look of this wormhole. That's really easy to do. I'm just going to open up the composition that we're using for the texture. And I'm going to drop in this photograph of a stormy sky. And this is not a tileable texture. So in order to make it tileable really quickly and easily, I'm going to right click it, come up to transform and click fit to comp. Then I'm going to twirl down those transform settings. And under scale, I'm just going to highlight one of these. It doesn't matter which one because they're still linked. And just hit divide by two. And now I'm just going to add the effect motion tile to it and expand the output width and the output height. And then just check mirror edges. And now you can still see the edges, which isn't great, but at least it's tileable now. So if we just go back into our main comp and see how that looks, you can see we have a completely different and, in my opinion, better look. As you can see, the fact that our texture wasn't really meant to be tiled didn't really cause us any problems. You can't really tell. But yeah, you guys, that's all I've got for this quick tip. I think this is probably the shortest and easiest tutorial that I have ever made. But I just thought that this trick was too easy and yet too useful to not share it with you guys. So anyway, my name is Adrian. This has been Toots Plus, and I thank you so much for watching. Bye.